Now fully vaccinated, the Locke family from Atlanta felt safe enough to visit New Orleans.
We did a lot of extra planning about what can we do that's outdoors, where can we eat and sit outdoors.
What worries me is if any of these COVID variants turn out to be worse than COVID-19, or if the vaccine does not protect you against them.
Some doctors are concerned about that too. In states like Michigan and New York, positivity rates remain high, even with vaccines. Dr. Julio Figueroa of LSU Health says a tourist city like this should pay attention.
If we have a lot of people coming in with the virus, that has the opportunity to then mutate and cause the problems with the variants of concern that we've seen in other parts.
As we're starting to see more people return to parks and other public places, Dr. Figueroa wants to remind the younger population that their age does not give them immunity from COVID.
Even if you have relatively little symptomatic disease, that you still have a substantial proportion of people who will go on to develop that other aspect of COVID-19. So they don't die, but they may have some sequelae downstream.
Some of those downstream issues include brain fog and loss of taste, which many COVID long haulers have reported. But if a fourth wave of COVID hits Louisiana, Dr. Figueroa believes vaccines and a year's worth of fighting the virus can keep hospitalizations and deaths relatively low.
And that would be the hope, you know, that we would be able to mitigate as much as possible the morbidity of the infection. And so we wouldn't be seeing a lot of hospitalizations and deaths relative to what it would have been if we didn't have a vaccinated population and a relatively younger population that's getting exposed.
With more restrictions being eased and the UK variant circulating, Dr. Figueroa believes Louisiana will see some kind of spike. But if more people get vaccinated and fewer people get hospitalized or die, then maybe we're seeing progress. Tan Trung, Eyewitness News.